All right, all we got left is a bunch of these. Very popular type of test questions, so get ready for these. I changed the layout here so it fit better on the screen, so mine kind of look like they're going down. Yours might be going across on your paper, so just pay attention to the letters. All right, can we tell if there's triangles congruent? If so, why, which is down here, and how are they congruent? Like triangle what is congruent to triangle what? We got to be careful on that because, of course, you could reorder them differently. All right, are these triangles congruent or not? Well, we have a side here, congruent to this side. We have a side here, congruent to this side. Was that enough to say they're going to be congruent? Well, that's two sides and two sides. Remember, the two statements we have so far are side, side, side. Sorry about my handwriting here. And we have side, angle, side. So with two sides so far, we need more. We need either another side or another angle or something. Well, look at how these are arranged. We have BD. That's the third side. That would complete this. But what's nice about BD is it's actually the same thing in both triangles. So, of course, it's congruent to itself. I can kind of think of it that way. That's going to work, and that's going to be by side, side, side. Let me type that. It's going to look a lot nicer. It's they're true by side, side, side. What's the statement on that? So if I called that triangle ABD, that would have to be congruent to triangle. I'll put the triangles in later. It'd be congruent. Okay, if I say A on one triangle, I think I'm going to have to say that's congruent to C on the other one. B on the left triangle, that connects the 2-tick and the 3-tick. That would have to be D on the other triangle to connect the 2-tick and the 3-tick. And the only other letter left in this one is B. Okay, let me fix that up. Okay, that's a little better. All right, are these congruent? Yes or no? Well, I've got a side. I've got a congruent to a side, so that's sort of one thing. It's easy to count this side and this side and go, oh, that's two sides. Oh, wait a minute. This is all about, you know, the stuff you have that matches in both triangles. So when I see AB is congruent to AD, that's really one side. I have an angle in the top triangle, congruent to an angle in the bottom triangle. Okay, so there's an angle. I need another side. Well, just like before, this is in both triangles. So I have yes again. And I have yes this time by SAS. And what angles do I have? I have... Well, let's call the top one AB. Whoa, how'd that happen? Let's call the top one ABC, and that's congruent to triangle. Well, if I say A in the top triangle, well, that angle there goes with that angle in the bottom triangle, so that's still A. B in the top triangle, it's the other end of the tick mark from where I started, so that has to go with D, and the other one left is C. Okay, let me clean that up. Yeah, so with the right notation and the congruence things I need to put in there. Okay, great. All right, this one. I've got a side and a side. That's two sides, so I should be looking either for, you know, is this third side congruent to this third side? Well, there's really no reason why that should be. What about the angle between the one tick and the two tick? Oh, look at that. That angle should be congruent to that angle by vertical. I don't have to say vertical in this type of problem. It's not asking me why is it vertical, or, you know, why is that angle true. It's just asking, you know, in the first place, is this congruent or not? Yeah, those are yes. What's the order on this one? Well, let's call it ABE on the left. That'd be congruent to, well, A on the one side lines up with, I guess it would be D on this side, right? It's the one tick side. I know E is going to go with itself. So this would be D, and E has to go with itself, so it has to go in this order. Okay. Bottom one, oh, let's just fix this. Put the triangles, it's really congruent. Sorry for the delay. Okay. On the bottom one, I have parallel. That's fun. I have a side and a side. This side's congruent to itself, so I can use that. Third side would be nice for side, 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 but there's no reason why really this angle should be, or sorry, this side should be congruent to this side. Angles, I have stuff like AIA. Like, I could say that angle is congruent to that angle. Is that the angle I want? Oh, turns out it is. Look at this bottom triangle. I have side, angle, side, congruent to top triangle, side, angle, side. So yes, this is going to be true by side, angle, side again. And if I say ABD on the left, I have to say, well, A on this triangle would have to go with C in the upper triangle if you look at that carefully. And this is kind of tricky. In the bottom triangle, if I say ABD, A to B to D, the third one I listed was the one with the single angle mark. In the top triangle, C and these other two, I want the third one to be the single angle mark, so I have to say it in this order. Which is it feels a little bit odd, but yeah, these are sort of twisted when they're congruent to each other. So that's slightly better looking notation. Sorry. All right, last couple. All right, we have two sides congruent to two sides. I could say I have vertical angles here. Yeah, that's great. But do I have side angle side or side side side? No, I don't. I have two sides and an angle, but this angle is not the angle that's between the two sides. So I can't say this is side angle side. It looks like it really ought to be, but it turns out that these two things, if I have the two sides and I have the angle next to it, it's not like I can call it side side angle or backwards, which would be something worse. I have to actually say I don't know these are congruent, because not only do we not like side-side angle because of the acronym, but we also don't like side-side angle because it's actually not even true. If you know side and then angle in one triangle is congruent to that stuff in the other triangle, it could be that these triangles are actually still not congruent. This side BE could be a whole lot longer than the CE, and this is not a valid triangle congruence arrangement. All right, down here, I have a shared side. Shared sides are nice. I know they're congruent to themselves in both triangles. The right angle in one is congruent to the right angle in another. So yeah, I've got side, angle, side here. I have the side DC, the angle between it, with the other side BD, and I have the same package kind of on the other one. So yeah, this is gonna be true by side, angle, side, and the triangles are ABD on the one side is congruent to, well, A in the first triangle has to go with C on the other triangle. D, the right angle, has to come last, so let's do it this way. This one's not twisted, sort of. This is just kind of straight backwards. This is really congruent, and these are really triangles. And I think that's it, correct? End of the worksheet. Okay, great. I'll see you in class. Thanks for watching.